UW360 is proudly supported by Pacific Office Automation, copy, print, workflow, and IT. Problem solved.
Welcome to the Living Computer Museum, the only place where you can compare a computer like this next to its great, many times over, great-grandfather, like one of these. Still fully functional and on display.
My main job here is to restore the old mainframes. I get to learn about these machines as I figure out how to fix them.
The interactivity of the exhibits is what sets the Living Computer Museum apart and is what makes it so accessible to people not entirely familiar with computing.
That's a philosophical bent of the founder of the museum, Paul Allen. He believes that a machine that just sits there is a lump of metal. It doesn't tell the story of the machine or the people who designed it, or of the software that runs on it, essentially.
That philosophy is working to span generations, as more and more people are getting interested in computing at younger and younger ages.
I like being able to interact with all of the computers and just type and see how it was before, because I didn't really know how big and clunky everything used to be.
That's the input.
There's a little kid out there who's learning how to program in Altair Basic. And he's just having a blast out there writing a program on an ancient machine.
I usually only code with a drag and drop blocks website called Scratch. I made quite a few interesting things there, such as, a stock market simulator.
Really?
It's really interesting.
That's awesome.
There is no question that the exhibits get people pumped about computing, which is why the Living Computer Museum has partnered with the University of Washington to reach out to up-and-coming programmers.
As faculty members at the University of Washington, one of our obligations, but also one of the great joys of our job, is to do outreach with the community.
Assistant Professor Kate Starbird and other leaders in computer science at the UW see a diverse, young generation of programmers as the future of computing. And getting more diverse students involved at earlier stages is critical.
I see the impact that all these technologies are having in so many aspects of our society, and I want a broader diversity of people whose hands are in the creation of those technologies.
Dr. Starbird has worked closely with the Living Computer Museum to design and host the annual Paul Allen Computing Challenge. Self-selected teams of middle and high school students spend 7 months performing tasks on data sets, in addition to designing and presenting their own research project under mentorship of graduate students from the UW.
I really look forward to the end of the year jamboree with the posters to really see what all the students have come up with. And not all of them are going to be, a research paper worthy, but some of them have been. Some of them have been really interesting questions and some really interesting findings that challenge current understandings of things.
The exhibits at the museum, programs like the Paul Allen Computing Challenge, and partnerships like those between the Living Computer Museum and the UW are only a few examples of how younger and more diverse students are getting involved in programming.
The connection to Living Computer Museum was what enabled me to be able to reach these kids and to have the impact that I was hoping to have.
The tools are always changing. And as new generations of computer engineers step up to sort out the designs of the future, it's nice to know that the Living Computer Museum will be here for us to reach out to the past. I'm Austin Seidenthoff, and I'll see you next time.